Hi students, welcome to Evershine Coaching Center. Myself Faisal sir here. Dear students, today I am going to start with Science Crash Course. So do remember here, these are the very 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 important questions which I have taken chapter wise. Is this clear? Good. And today we are going to start the Science Crash Course for SSLC students or class 10 students. These questions are very important for all the boards. Let it be state board or CBSE board students. Both of you can follow these questions. Are you getting my point? Yes. Now, dear students, I'll be going to give you the various types of questions here. Please make a note of this and try to find the solution for that. The reason why I am not giving solutions here, because first you have to ensure yourself whether you know the answer for that or not. Second, you try your level best to find the solution for that. When you are trying to find the solution, maybe you are learning something extra points also, rather than this question solution. Okay, you may get some extra points so that it may be helpful for you people to attend some other questions also. That is the reason. In case if you are not finding the solution, so please you can put in the comment box which question number. You can just write the question number, just brief title of the question, something. I'll get back to you the solution. If you want explanation, I can give you the explanation. If you want answer, I will try to provide the answer for you people. Okay, then you can just carry on further. Let's start with this session. This is day one of Science Crash Course. First question, what is observed when solution of potassium iodine solution is added to a solution of lead nitrate? Here what is the question is asking, what you are going to observe? While we are doing the experiment, what is that experiment? When a solution of potassium iodine solution, we have taken a potassium iodine solution, we are adding that to the solution of lead nitrate. Definitely when these two reactants combines together, one product is formed, right? But here what is the question? See, this is the main condition. Now, based on this condition, he is asking you to find the solution for sub-questions. What is the sub-question? Name the type of reaction. So, which type of reaction is carried out during this process? Then you should write the balanced chemical equation to represent the above chemical reaction. Then you have to write the balanced chemical equation. Okay. Can we use any other lead compound in place of lead nitrate? Instead of lead nitrate, do you think can we use some other compound also? That is what he is about to ask in this problem. Is this clear? देखो बेटा इस problem में क्या पूछा गया है? Solution of potassium iodine के अंदर हम solution of lead nitrate को mix कर रहे हैं. Potassium iodine के अंदर lead nitrate को जब हम mix करेंगे, तो एक reaction होगा. तो उस reaction का नाम क्या है? Okay? Then you should write the balanced equation for that. उसका एक balanced equation लिखना है. और उसके साथ साथ और एक एक आपको एक जनरल क्वेश्चन पूछा जा रहा है. ही इज आस्किंग सम जनरल क्वेश्चन. ओके, कैन वी यूज एनी अदर लेड कॉम्पाउंड इन प्लेस ऑफ लेड नाइट्रेट? लेड नाइट्रेट की जगह कोई और कॉम्पाउंड का इस्तेमाल हो सकता है क्या? दिस इज फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, ये व्हाइट साल्ट ऑन हीटिंग डिकम्पोजर्स टू गिव ब्राउन फ्यूम्स एंड ए रेसिड्यू इज लेफ्ट बिहाइंड. जब हम एक व्हाइट साल्ट को हीट कर रहे हैं तो डिकम्पोज होने के बाद उसके अंदर से ब्राउन फ्यूम्स निकलेंगे. Okay, once if it get decomposed, what happens? Brown color fumes are going to be liberated and some residue is left out. Okay, now the question is, name the salt. So which is the salt is obtained, and next write the equation. During this reaction, what is happening? What was the reactant and what is the product? You should write the balanced chemical reaction and name the type of reaction. So which type of reaction has taken place during this process? Next question. Write chemical equation, reactions taking place when carried out with the help of, okay, when iron reacts with steam, what happens? When iron reacts with steam, see children, steam means you have to use H2O, okay, don't forget. So when iron reacts with steam, what happens? This sentence you have to convert into chemical reaction, okay, you have to write the sentence as well as you should balance the chemical reaction and show them. Same way, magnesium reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid. What happens? Copper is heated in air. Copper is heated in air. Air means you can take it as O2. So when what happens when copper reacts with O, oxygen, that's nothing but air. Next question. Write the chemical equation involved in the following reaction. So which type of chemical equation is involved during this reaction? Whitewashing, black and white photography. Okay, which type of chemical equation is involved? Is this clear? Good. Next question. What is a redox reaction? What do you mean by redox reaction? Next, when a magnesium ribbon burns in air with a dazzling flame, you already know it in combination reaction in the first page of your textbook, of your chapter, this reaction has been given to you. But here, something differently they are asking you the question. Based on the same activity, they are asking something different. Let's see what is that. When we burn the magnesium ribbon, what happens? We get a dazzling flame and it forms a white ash. One white color ash is going to be produced. Okay. Now the question is, okay, till here we know the concept. Now what is the question they are asking from this title of the question? Is magnesium is oxidized or reduced? During this process, the magnesium is oxidized or it is reduced. They are asking you to identify what is happening. Whether it is a where magnesium is getting oxidized or it is getting reduced, and you have to give the reason for that. Why? Okay. Next question. Explain two ways by which food industries prevent rancidity. You have seen so many food industries are there to prevent rancidity condition, spoilage of food condition. So what are the ways, which are the different ways they are going to use to prevent rancidity? Next. Discuss the importance of decomposition reaction in metal industry. See children, decomposition reaction is there, right? Even you can see that we have different types of decomposition reactions. Okay. Now the question is, they can ask you the uses with a particular application. So you should be careful in that type of question. You cannot write the uses of decomposition reaction, applications of decomposition reactions, whichever you know. No, it is not like that. You can see they have given the hint. What they have given the hint? They are saying that in metal industry, they are asking you to write the answer with respect to metal industry. Okay, you have to write the importance of decomposition reaction. Some 3 points they are asking you to write with respect to metal industry. Next question. On heating blue colored powder of copper nitrate in boiling tube, copper oxide, oxygen gas and brown color gas, that is excess form. See. When you are going to heat blue colored powder of copper nitrate in a boiling tube, what happens? Copper oxide, it's a black in color, oxygen gas and brown color gas X. Which is that X? We doesn't know. Okay. So brown color gas is there. You have to name that. I think they may ask you. Yeah, they are asking you to X. Identify X. Okay, anyways. So brown color gas is going to be obtained. It's going to be formed. I'm going to give that brown color gas as X. Now, what is the sub question they are asking here? Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction. Identify brown gas X evolved. So which is that X gas? What is the name of that gas they are asking you? Okay. And next, identify the type of reaction. Which type of reaction is involved during this process? What could be the pH range of aqueous solution of the gas X? So what may be the pH value of that? Next, they are asking you to balance the following equations like HNO3 plus CaOH twice gives CNO3 twice plus H2O. Okay. So we have got different reactions over here. So try to balance it. Okay, like this type of questions also you can expect. Any doubt? Good. We can balance these reactions. Next, what do you mean by precipitation reaction? Explain by giving some examples. Some 2 examples you can give and you can just tell them what do you mean by precipitation reaction. Next, what is neutralization reaction? Give an example. Why does distilled water not conduct electricity whereas rainwater does? Right, distilled water, from distilled water we cannot produce the electricity, but from rainwater we can do it. Why? You should give the reason for that. Next, metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescence. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. Okay, when metal A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid, what happens? It produces effervescence. Okay, it's like bubbles in a liquid, bubbles kind of formation is going to be produced. It produces effervescence. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. Now they are asking you, write the balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compound forms is calcium chloride. Next, Sugandha prepares hydrochloric HCl, hydrochloric acid, HCl gas. Sugandha prepares hydrochloric gas in a school laboratory using certain chemicals. Okay, using HCl gas, she is performing different types of experiments. She puts both dry and wet litmus paper in contact with the gas. She has taken red litmus paper and she has taken blue litmus paper with contact with the gas. The gas is coming out. She has taken both the types of litmus papers. Now the question is, name the reagent used by Sugandha to prepare HCl gas. So what are the reagents she has used? What are the raw materials she has used to prepare this HCl gas? Reagents she has used to prepare HCl gas. State the color change observed with dry and wet litmus paper. So what happens for red litmus paper and what happens for blue litmus paper? Dry and wet litmus paper. First she has taken red litmus paper and then she has taken dry and wet litmus paper. So what is the color change she is going to observe? See children, they are not given here red and blue. You can, if it is possible, try to better write what happens for red litmus paper with respect to dry and wet condition, what happens to blue litmus paper with respect to dry and wet condition. You can tell that. Show the formation of ions when HCl gas combines with water. So how the ions formation takes place, plus and minus ions. Is this clear? Good. Next question. Explain the importance of pH in our daily life. So we have got different topics with respect to pH in our daily life in your textbook. Children, this topic is very, very, very important. From this, they can extract 1 mark question also, or 2 mark or 3 mark question also. So you should be careful with respect to this question. You should refer all the points of this topic, pH in our daily life. Next, what is chloralkali process? What do you mean by chloralkali process? Explain the extraction of sodium hydroxide, that is caustic soda, by this process. Name the products obtained during this process. A dry pellet of a common base B, when kept in open, absorbs moisture and turns sticky. The compound is also a byproduct of chloralkali process. Okay, so in this title of this question, they are asking you to identify what is that B is formed, what type of reaction occurs when B is treated with an acidic oxide, write a balanced chemical equation on for one such solution. Okay, next. A white powder is added while baking breads and cakes to make them soft and fluffy. Write the name of the powder. Name its main ingredients. Explain the function of each ingredient. Write the chemical reaction taking place when the powder is heated during baking. Next, write the chemical name of plaster of Paris. What is the chemical name? And write the chemical equation of its preparation. Why should plaster of Paris be stored in a dry place? Next question. For the preparation of hydrogen gas, what would happen if following changes are made while you are preparing hydrogen gas? Okay, actually something is happening, zinc granules, those things we are heating, right? But here, instead of that, in case if you are using this, what happens? That is what the question here. In place of zinc granules, same amount of zinc dust is taken in the test tube. In place of zinc granules, same amount of zinc dust, if you have taken in the test tube, what happens? Instead of granules, if you have taken zinc dust, what happens? Instead of dilute sulfuric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid is taken. What happens? In place of zinc, copper turnings are taken. What happens? Sodium hydroxide is taken in place of dilute sulfuric acid and the tube is heated. What happens? So they are asking you what happens in case if you take this instead of this, some other condition if you use, what happens? They are asking you, they are asking us to identify. Next, a substance X used in the kitchen for making tasty crispy pakodas and is also an ingredient of antacid. Name the substance X. How does X help to make cakes and bread soft and spongy? Is the pH value of the solution of X is less than or greater than 7? So you have to identify what is the pH value. It is less than 7 or greater than 7. If it is acidic in nature, then you can tell it is less than 7. If it is basic in nature, then you can tell it is greater than 7. Next, a substance X is used as an antacid, reacts with hydrochloric acid to produce a gas Y, which is used in fire extinguisher. Name the substance X and gas Y, which is the substance X, and what is the name of the gas Y. Write the balanced chemical reaction between X and hydrochloric acid. Okay, first you have to identify which is the substance. That substance, once if it reacts with hydrochloric acid, what is the product is going to be form, or it is going to be octane. You should tell over there. Next, five solutions we have taken. As an example, A, B, C, D, and E. When tested with universal indicator, showed pH as 4, 1, 11.7 and 9 respectively. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A, B, C, D, E. 5, right? Yeah. First is 4, 1. Next is 11. That is not dot. It is comma. Okay. 7 and 9 respectively. Which solution is neutral? Strongly alkaline, strongly acidic, weakly alkaline. And arrange the pH in increase order of hydrogen ion concentration. You need to identify in this which is neutral and which is strongly alkaline. 4, 1, 11, 7, 9 out of this. A milkman adds a very small amount of baking soda to fresh milk. Why does he shift the pH of the fresh milk from 6 to slightly alkaline? Why is doing this? Why he wants to make the solution alkaline? He is asking. Why you want to change the pH? Why does this milk take a long time to curd as curd? What is the reason behind that? You should tell. I hope you all have understood these questions, right? So if you have any doubts, children, or if you want any explanation regarding these questions or the topics which I have given here, so you can comment me in the below box. I'll try to find the solutions for that. If you want the notes of those questions, you can let me which question you are not getting the, you are not finding the answer, you can tell me. I'll just share the notes to you people. Okay. And if you want any explanation also, you can let me know. I'll try to find the solutions for that. So don't forget to share, like, comment and subscribe this channel. I hope you all have enjoyed this session. So this is the end of day one of Science Crash Course. So try to find the solution for these all questions. And tomorrow in the next class, we come back with day two with some other different types of questions. Thank you for watching this video. Best of luck. Do that. Bye.